Hello everybody, and welcome to this very special event showcasing the selected plays from London Playwrights Blog's Play Club scheme. I'm Georgie, and I'm the Literary Projects Manager for London Playwrights Workshop, and have been for a couple years now. So I help manage and create projects for writers at any stage of their career, both in courses, workshops, schemes, one-to-one development, all of those kind of things. So I have a lot of fun, basically. A bit about London Playwrights Blog. So we started in 2013 as a resource for emerging playwrights. We aim to bring together the latest opportunities, best resources and good advice all in one place, which is on our blog. In 2015, the team formed London Playwrights Workshop Limited as a non-profit company to help expand this support for writers through workshops, events and expanded online resources. Some of our past projects, which you may know us for, include the Making It podcast, which was made in collaboration with Temi Wilkie and the Bush Theatre, as well as our Write a Play scheme, which encourages writers to write a play throughout the month of January, which is currently open for sign-ups. So please do join us for Write a Play in January and get that play written with us. It's going to be a lot of fun. And then obviously also Play Club, which we are here to celebrate today. We also offer projects all year round, and we release updated resources regularly alongside our script consultancy packages, which you can find out more about on the website. Most recently, though, we've become associates at the Lion Unicorn Theatre, where we hope to support writers even further through practical workshops, schemes and projects in collaboration with the lovely folk at the venue. So that's going to be really exciting for us coming into the next year to be able to, hopefully, fingers crossed, do some more face-to-face work with writers. The six plays you're about to see are all of our selections from our Play Club projects, which is now in its second year of life, following a successful initial year in 2019, where four plays received rehearsed readings at the Old Red Lion back in December. This year we've had to run this final event slightly differently, as you can tell, from the comfort of my own living room. We're having to do it online due to the pandemic, which is a shame for us because we love working practically and in person with actors and directors on different writers' pieces. But we hope you'd agree that this still gives a strong opportunity to showcase and develop these pieces further, and gives them a bit of longevity online as well. So what is Play Club? I know you're burning to know. So for the last 12 months, we've challenged writers to read a play a month and then respond to that play in the month following. And then from all of our submitted plays, we then selected one from each text. And they're the pieces that you're about to see, basically. This final showcase is intended to help these pieces develop either as shorter plays or longer works. And we'll get some industry feedback on these plays as well. And we've got a wonderful cast of actors and two directors who've worked on these pieces to give them a basic life and understanding. But we hope you'll agree they've done quite a fantastic job on that. So big kudos to them. And yeah, they've really saved my bacon, which has been lovely. We'll be watching the first three plays uninterrupted. So this is how the night is going to run. So the first three plays that we'll watch will be Methods of Killing Your Leader by Simon Jenner, Bulbs by Corene, Lemaitre, and then followed by The Wait by Teresa, Espejo, before heading to a brief 5-minute interval to get a drink or to let the dog out or, you know, whatever you need to do in your house or wherever you're watching from, before we then head on to our final three plays, which are Juno's Swans by Rupert, Mallin, The Gyal is Mama of the Mar by Sam, Palmyra, and Be Careful by Fiona Black. Once these plays have been performed, you'll then see my face again, which I know you cannot wait for an outro of the evening and to just let you know a bit more about the projects that we run. If you can spare some change, any donations are welcome to continue to support London Playwrights Blog so we can continue to develop the next generation of playwrights. There'll be a link for donations in the description box, I believe, in this YouTube link. But just see if you can find it down there, basically. Anyway, without any further ado of me waffling on and on, please enjoy the first three plays, starting with Methods. Let me try that again. But without further ado, please enjoy the first three plays, starting with Methods of Killing Your Leader by Simon Jenner.
Workers typing messages to each other, Elle's first day.
So glad to be working here.
Welcome.
Comrade.
Yeah, you sound.
Ha ha.
Joking. Comrade. Lol.
Sorry, I'm new.
You don't say. Oh, Don't say welcome, comrade, to any of us ever again. Joke?
In it. You're Mandy's niece. Said you were fine.
Bit out of my depth, TBH.
You're done.
We're critical fans. Mandy told you. She's with us.
Of... Sorry, newbie, I said.
Leader and teacher. One with the trotters, adored by piglets. Lots of trots. Have you had them?
Trotters?
Yeah. Don't mean have you had a trot, though. Never know. No, pigs trotters, because you're north, aren't you?
Salford and proud. And no, never tried. That's so last century.
Stay out and proud.
I mean, not gay.
Oops, disadvantage, straight off.
Right.
Trace is teasing.
We're Sharon and Trace, and you, L, must be the element we're looking for. Get it? X.
Thanks. Been called. Have to go.
She's dim. We're going to have trouble.
The thing about North is left but trad. Sort of dead centre.
Solid. No use.
Spear carrier. So, what you got?
Enough to hang. Blunt those investigations. Tell papers it's dear leader's office. Got Channel 4?
Still Jim's purview. Any trot crying in toilets, we tell Jim. He dials fave political reporter.
Who?
Wills.
Wills hates everyone. He's dobbing Jim.
Well, Jim's like shrimp in an enemy with Wills.
Question mark, question mark, question mark.
LP Hartley. One starts eating the other, but pull them apart, they both die. Lol. Don't like Jim or Wills much. Useful idiots.
Oh, do not use such trot language ever again, lol.
Keris is back. Manky. Makes a virtue signal three suits.
Duff, as in up?
Fat. Like men want that bra too small. Hope's only under 25 men see that, but they don't even notice.
Hate that trot. She drew up selection for Lotto.
Written invisible ink. Fat from under her armpit, so Lotto loyalists hold a UV and read it.
Disgusting! You're a degenerate, Shaw.
Thanks, one, Trace. You seen that OMG cute intern, blonde, 27, geek, amazingly total ungeek. Shame and waste a trot. Idealist. Believes in the project and is working for Lotto. Friend of Sun.
Rising star. Makes me vom. We're invisible. Can someone turn him?
Elle picks up. Nice looking fuckwit. Pity she's got no brains. No idea of us or him.
Honey trap one. Out. Denise?
Two out with her right foot for Lotto. Nobble your leader. So working man's fiend, so sincere, so adored by roaring smelly things under stones who crawl out, hiss, and vote at GE.
Ah, the public thought they'd been abolished.
They'd elect another.
But virtual.
Got it. Harassment. Worse. L, a fool girl. Explain away some shit to Mandy, but I got it.
How?
Delete thread. Memorise. We'll tell all.
Matter?
Yeah, like you're quiet.
Things to be quiet about?
We're your, if not friends, yet friendly colleagues who want the best. Tell me.
Don't want hashtag me too moment, but gross.
Tell me.
Not here. Coffee.
In confidence, but we have robust procedures, as of need.
Blood test positive. Wanna thank you so much. Have decided formal and I'm taking 3 days. Consider position. Isolate from male colleagues.
Yes. OMG, we got it all. Trace, your element.
How?
Dark arts. There's Mickey in there somewhere.
WTF?
Handed it to Cutie in drinks. Intro'd them. Like Cupid, he hands it to her. Too much noise and no one notices. 5 minutes, see her collapse just outside Lotto. He takes her in.
Wow. So, outfall?
Wakes up in Lotto. Really gets something's happened. Spite. So I've followed. Put my arm. Say to Clot of Trots, piss off. This is my friend's niece. I'll take care. Before they object, get her out. Say, is it Cutie or maybe older member and really play with that while she's muzzy. Near bullseye. Not Lotto, but a Lotto win. Cutie. She says him.
You unpardonable Machiavel. You top BH. Now, delete.
Can't talk.
Okay. Whenever you feel right.
Want to thank you for clearing this up, Josh. So happy you're in the clear. Yeah, Leader told me the gist in person. What? This legal? I mean, you hacked. Okay. Shoot. OMG, cute intern, blonde, 27, geek. Amazingly total ungeek, shame and waste of trot. Yeah, we knew they were right-thinking gals. Solid no use. Flattering. Mandy'll be... What? Handed it to Cutie and drinks, intro'd them like Cupid. He hands it to her, too much noise, so no one notices. Really get something happened, spiked, so I followed. And really play with that while she's muzzy near bullseye. No. Enough said.
Mean, at least secure. Not party phones.
Shelagh, have you seen? It's in paper, like legal. You must have it. Your advice will be criminal charges.
Fucking geek. Was planted.
Was suspended. How did he get per?
Lotto's son swung it. Said why he was brought in.
To investigate. Someone playing us.
All the time. Thought we were in deepest.
Heard about that Judas cutie and fuckwit northern lass.
No wheels got it and going to splash their pics. Want to splash acid in their smug faces. Jim said before he cut me off. They got to Wills first. They'll get to Jim. All of us.
Don't ever want to work in an office again. Or where there's chat or people. Think I want to speak. You know, in front of people I can see. Rip out hate. Want love in the open, hate in the open. Don't want any of this shit wiring ever. Ever. I know it's your world. You get me? Yeah. Josh, you've always had my back. Always will. When can I come and touch your voice?
My mother is dead. She'd been in intensive care for weeks. It's okay. I'm over it. Well, I'm not. I'm here, clearing out her flat. I've been putting it off. Council's telling me to get a move on. Death moves so fast. Bit messy. Mum was all about the chaos, including emotional. There's always something going on. Some drama, situation, something. But she was the best mum in the world. I had green thumbs, she said. It's true. Anything I planted grew. Mum preferred bulbs. They were easy. But I always felt there was a gardener in her, struggling to get out. It's so odd. Death, isn't it? Where is she? Seems like she ought to be here. In the kitchen making puddings. In the living room, chatting on the phone. She'd love to talk. We're in the bedroom with a pile of newspapers. She was always clipping articles, and I knew why. Anyway, I'm hoping this whole process will give me some closure. Not handling it too well, to be honest. Found these. On the couch, wrapped in newspaper, her bulbs. Every year she'd buy some from the local garden shop. She'd wrap them in newspaper and stash them somewhere. Come planting time, she'd place them in a bowl full of pebbles with mortar. Paper white, she'd call them, kind of daffodil. And every so often, she'd pour a glass of vodka over them to keep them from getting leggy, she said. In a few weeks, they'd bloom and they'd stink. Like poo and rot. That was the scent of my childhood, the sickly, sweet stench of paper whites. I found some other things. My birth certificate, no father listed, in a box with all these clippings from newspapers and magazines. All stories of the same man. Politician, married with kids, confident, charming. Not the sort to let anyone or anything disrupt his life. Well, I better get on with this. Not sure what to do with these bulbs. Throw them out, probably. I planted them, the bulbs. I thought, why not? I chucked them out, but I heard a voice in my head. Get them back. It boomed, so I did. Scoot them out of the rubbish with my bare hands. Their skin rough and flaky, like Mum's. She was always rubbing lotion into her hands. She worked so hard. We never had much, but she made sure I had what I needed the most. Decent clothes, money for class trips, music lessons. She herself would go without, but she never complained. She was clever, could cook and mend, made what money we had running a market store on Portobello Road. We were a team. Anyway, I retrieved the bulbs, and as I stood there holding them, I thought, plant them and she'll come back. Simple as that. If I plant the bulbs, she'll return, walking through the door just like old times. I feel good about this. They're starting to grow. Every so often, I pour a glass of vodka over them as my mother did. One for you, one for me, I'd say, and I'd down the glass myself. Things are pretty good, actually. The man in the newspaper clippings, oh, so obvious. I've got his chin and his number from a journalist I know. When I rang, he knew exactly who I was. I'd only just said hello when he hung up on me, when I'd hoped he'd be glad to hear from me. Want to make up for lost time, but no. Well, that's okay, because I know exactly what to do. To this man, who got my mother pregnant and denied her, denied me. I'm going to the press. There are going to be a few more clippings. My mother is dead, but my father is alive. And I'm going to raise a stink. They grew, the paper whites. They bloomed for 2 weeks. The scent was incredible. It filled my flat. I'd go to sleep with that stench in my nostrils as in childhood. It was like my mother was there. Ghostly white, like the flowers. A bit leggy. I'd wake and I think I saw her, sipping vodka and smiling. But there'd be nothing there. After a while, I thought, I have to find a way to deal with this. As if in confirmation, Mum appeared to me in a dream. It's time to move on, she said, gently. She hugged me. I could feel her arms, smell her sweet, rotting scent, the scent of earth and life and love. I woke. I realised I didn't need to crush this man who was my father, for he was no father. What I did do was apply for a course in horticulture, one of my dreams and something my mother would have wanted for me. I've made up my mind to do a lot of things to grow, like one of those bulbs. It's funny, things have a way of working out. I have a sister. Turns out I wasn't my father's only out-of-wedlock child. One morning I checked the headlines to find his face splashed all over the news, along with that of a woman claiming to be his daughter. I reached out. She was lovely. Her mum, as fierce as mine. We're friends now. Family. And it's like my mother's here, still loving me.
Fuck!
I don't know yet.
Fuck!
Jim, stop it.
How?
Well, when a man and a woman lay in bed...
Fuck's sake, Lydia!
What kind of a question is that? How? You already know the mechanics. I don't know yet. I haven't peed on it yet.
Okay. Well, do your thing.
I'm trying, but you keep distracting me.
Sorry.
I don't know if I can go now.
By how, I meant when, okay?
The last time we did it? About 3 weeks ago, I think.
Has it been that long?
Really? Yeah, it's been that long. Remember, you forgot to get condoms at Sainsbury's.
Are you blaming me already?
I'm not blaming you.
I forgot.
Well, you did.
You said you'd get them next time you went to the shop.
So now it's my fault.
It's no one's fault. It could just be your...
Just me?
Your periods tend to do weird stuff.
It's been a month or more since my last period.
You've been stressed recently.
Jim!
It could be that, couldn't it? Can't you drink like a herbal tea? Or...
A herbal tea?
Yeah.
Right. Why haven't I thought about that before? All those years on the pill when I could have just had a mint tea?
That's not what I meant.
What the fuck did you mean? I knew this would happen. You knew, let me stick it inside for a bit. I knew one day you'd get too excited.
Wait a minute. I didn't hear anyone objecting at the time.
We've been playing with fire and now we've been punished.
By who?
We deserve this for being irresponsible.
You sound like a religious fanatic right now. I'm sure that...
It's a baby. It's a human being with needs and wants and... Oh, God, we can't afford it. We couldn't afford to have a cat. We couldn't even afford to upgrade the broadband. We are so fucked.
That is not true. We're not.
What, the broadband?
We want to have babies.
Now is not the time to have a bloody baby.
We will figure this out. Look, we can figure this out together.
Please, you sound like a pop song. What are we going to do if I'm pregnant? You've been furloughed and we have a mortgage. Maybe I should just start playing the lottery.
You are still working.
My salary is not enough.
I could work for my dad, doing some plumbing.
Oh my God, are you being serious?
Of course.
That's cute, but he's not getting much work these days.
Things won't stay like this forever.
This won't go away anytime soon.
So, if we are pregnant...
How, Jim?
It might be stress.
Maybe, but you came...
Please, let's not do that.
Sorry. This is not how I wanted to have a baby. Do you want to have a baby? Because
no.
You said those things before.
I mean, not yet. I was just being supportive.
So you didn't mean any of it?
Look, if you want to have it...
Right. I'm making the big decision.
Yes, I'd support you.
Ultimately... It is my decision, because it's growing inside me. Like, I can't run away from it. You could.
I don't.
Me? No chance. Can't hide it either. You, on the other hand, could carry on living your life, and no one would know I'm pregnant unless you told them.
I would.
Fuck! I can't be pregnant.
You're probably not.
Stop echoing all my thoughts with answers.
I'm just...
Jim! Why didn't we get the bloody condoms? We are so bloody lazy and reckless. We can't have children. We're not ready. Imagine. What am I going to do? We don't want the baby. And how does that work, by the way? Do I just call the GP and say, I think I'm pregnant? Or do they have to check again? Is there a waiting list? Do we need another appointment? I heard you can take a pill if you're less than... Shit, I need to find out. See? You don't have to worry about any of this. We get rid of the baby and it's me that has to make all the bloody appointments and sort out the logistics and go through the process and fuck, I'm a bloody murderer. I kill it. All my fault. It's always the woman's fault. And I know that's bullshit, but I will take that guilt with me. And for the rest of my days, I'll have the occasional what if moment. What if we had the baby? What if she was a girl? Who would she take after? Fuck. Okay, start echoing again. I think I'm gonna have a panic attack.
You feel like peeing now?
I think so. I can't be pregnant. I'm just bloody stressed. Okay. Let's do this. Oh,
sorry, what's the glass for?
It's easier if you pee in a container and then dip.
What, you disgusting creature. Okay, put a sticker on that glass so I don't ever drink from it again, okay? That was quick.
Don't need too much to make it work.
So.
What? Not yet. I need to wait.
How long?
3 minutes. Well, about 2.5 now.
So.
Not yet.
Oh, is it bad news? I mean, not bad news, but what is it? I didn't mean bad. Like, whatever it is, it's good. Yeah? But what is it? Baby?
No baby.
I can't understand.
No baby! I'm not pregnant!
Oh! Sorry, are we not happy, or...?
Yeah, we're happy!
Okay. Tears of joy.
I'm just fucking stressed!
It's okay.
We need to get condoms.
Rosie prepares a picnic. There's a tartan rug, a hamper, and long French breadsticks in a basket. Rosie is played by a woman in a romantic dress, beneath which she is dressed as a man. She sings the following as she sets out the picnic.
Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of posies. Ashes, ashes, we all fall down. Here we are, an idyllic spot for a picnic, with wine, laughter, and love. Far from the metropolis, what an English summer is this? Well, all around is pestilence and disease, and though the apocalypse is everywhere on learned lips, what care I in this Viridian countryside heaven of our quarantine? My lover was on my breath as I woke. Every aspect of myself this morning I made for love, from the pencil pleasure on my lips to the sparkle of my insteps. Oh, my love, I chattered like a sparrow to you in my early morning mirror. Teeth to televise, lips as lush as laziness. Am I not softer than the frost? I tempted you. Will I be your lick of ice cream then? Or the icing on your cake? How I teased you in my reflection. So here I wait for love, spread out on the bank of the River Stour, quintessential England from John Constable's brush. It's another country. Here, my love can hide and seek in the copse, cuckooing, or the grassy knolls and hayricks under rolling skies until the naughty boy is caught by the bye. Look how the sun rises to kiss our budding valley. Oh, these heartbeats to my lover's coming are like betrayal. I cannot wait, but do not want love tinged with hate.
Rosie picks up one of the long French sticks of bread. It's both a sword and a phallus. She duels with her lover.
Chivalrous to the last I am, but every moment is lost is love's loss. Unsheath yourself and let's go sword to sword. En garde! Prêt! Aha! Lunge and thrust! Parry! Parry! Lunge and thrust! Up to the bloody hilt! Hark! Who comes here? It is just the deer, weary of the chase in the shelter of the shadows, their antlers hornier than a crown. Perhaps my lover's father has uncovered our sweet love, or the mother, draconian in attitudes and down-lipped like a man. Has she locked love in its seething cell, forced to part the fuse which binds? But what mothers rent asunder flaming pokers impregnate? Let the bastards rule.
Rosie breaks the French stick over her knee.
Broken bread. My body aches. What solace here? I would that I could drink all the wine, but then this star-crossed wretch would be cross-eyed in my lover's face. We slept together. Yes, yes, yes. Rose petals fell around us. Yes, yes, yes. Raw we were. But not from thorns. Oh, dearest, why desert me now? Yes, I dread. No, you'll soon be handcuffed to another. But you'll have one hand left free for me. And see, both my hands are free. Yet what a prison is this freedom. I ache to be with you, to be me. And if you have now forsaken me, let the swans be torn apart as the river runs dry. Leave me mute and thoughtless. Let life leave me as a vapour. Oh, vapour me. Evaporate away. Hark. Bells strike. Struck by Nayland Church, ringing in the hour. Six. Seven. Eight. Eight. That was eight. Where's 9 o'clock? That was not 9 o'clock. Oh, I'm... Oh, cock-a-hoop! I am cocky and I'm lucky. My lover is not late, but I am early. The early bird who's so smitten cannot tell the time.
Rosie dances.
We learn and play together. We eat together. Before all nature, we are coupled together in this forever. This love, this timelessness.
She stops dancing. Her dress falls. She becomes a man. Doing up his trousers and shirt, straightening himself, he looks down at the dress as if rosy.
Clothe yourself, girl. The pain is spent. Make decent. Time is pressing. Business plans, wedding plans, all calling. My lady requires your attendance. We'll be spliced under the county's autumn brown in black and white. You know it all, my plans. Come on. Rise. I am risen. Twice. They say the plague's whipping round the cities and the poor. Rosie, you're safe here, and your job too. Stick to what I say, and all is well. You've a roof and food, and you're guarded well. Let not silly pride unmask you now. Oh, what a heaven here. The valley so sweet for veal. And all is poetry. See how the river ripples with the sky, how the water gossips in the reeds. The swans! I'd like to tell you about how I swam with swans. Swam with them in the old swan pit. Beauty makes a noble feast. But that was long, long ago. I'm sorry, Rosie. All this is over. Mother says I must not take my lover into marriage. She commands it. And father, well, he cares not a jot, of course, but for the reading of the banns without a hitch and that the I do's are done and dusted quick. You knew all my life's been groomed for this. Not just a union of two, but a bond of families, for all our interests. I grew up with her. Indeed, until I came of age, I thought she was my sister. Heavens above. And now I bed her.
He kneels down by the dress and, looking around, pins her down. He whispers in her imaginary ear.
Look, sweet girl, I'm not saying we cannot unleash the sword and scabbard when it itches hot. But all must now be discreet. A long, long shh. and so well hidden. There'll be no time for hide and seek, but a rush, a brazen thrust of love in a lonely stairwell cupboard. So this is not goodbye.
He kisses the imaginary Rosie.
Au revoir, my little signet. Come. Wake up from your slumber. Your job is calling. Mother, I am ready to be a man. I am. Ready for business. Ready to take a county slice for a piece of cake. On top of it, two swans of whitest icing intertwined in a translucent kiss. Me and my betrothed, Elizabeth, my bride.
He kicks the dress, then picks up a corner of the garment.
Here, Mummy. I've killed off love for you.
Blackout.
So, here we are, home, a little home. Oh, you curled in my tummy, and me curled with my cushion. And both of us curled like maggots in a tin, like Daddy used to do his fishing. Do you remember that? No, of course you don't. It's all new to you. It went years ago. You don't know nothing. You got everything to learn, how to earn, and I'm going to teach you. What do we need? Each other. Maybe the walls are wet. Maybe there's a cockroach under the bed. He's hungry too. We can all live together. We all need each other. And we all got to help each other. And you, lay off. I don't do that stuff anymore. All we want is to be left alone and suffer a little. Is that too much to ask? We're not taking your shit anymore. We got our own shit. We march to our own song. We got our own battles. We ain't scared of nothing. We don't care if you're watching or not. We've had enough and we ain't showing you no more booty. We demand you give us respect and we demand what we deserve.
Gyal, ain't I taught you nothing? That was shit. Who's caring? No punter and his sister, they don't give a fuck about little Missy whistling in her cushion corner. You scared them off.
I ain't hardly started.
You finished before you started. You got no clicks. You're doing it all wrong. You don't tighten the neck up. You loose it down. But show a little. Nothing too much. Gloves on. You help the gentlemen so they click and collect. That's what it's called. Clips for sale, not Missy Two Shoes telling her baby a night-night story.
From now on, I'm doing this my own way.
Look, Gyal, you just tried it. I'll give you the chance. You've got nothing. Zilch in spades. Let me show you.
I don't need showing.
You think that? You need me. You don't realise what I do for you.
I know what you do for me. You turn me a liar. And I know some people out there, they don't like to be tricked. They want the truth. They like to see a girl struggle to make herself better. And they pay for that because it warms their miserable get-a-life hearts.
That's why they're clicking like cockroaches, yeah?
It's a different audience.
Men is men is men. If he's got a dick and a wallet,
you got to give it time.
And time we haven't got. Oh, come in. Oh, please come in, punters, one and all. Welcome to my humble home. Have a drink. Cheers. This is my little girl, which is a big thing for me. And welcome you to come in and pleasure yourself. Some folks are here. Yeah. Some guys, even the young ones, they like an older woman. A little bony and raddled. It gives them the thrill of their mama's dreams in the bathroom when they're small.
I feel sorry for you.
You see, I told you.
I feel very sorry.
And I'm telling you all, we don't want your sorry. We want your money.
I want to understand.
I'll help you. I will.
Don't take no heed of her. We don't want you to understand because that is too big a gift for us poor scum to give you, bastards. You go find your understanding somewhere else. Because my little girl and me, we have got everything we need. Ain't that right? Just so long as you give us tribute. So get it on or fuck off.
I can tell. You're a sensitive, understanding guy.
I want the little one.
I ain't doing it, Mama.
Yes, you is. You're doing it like I tell you, girl. Come on, show some leg and show some chest. We need the cash.
Can't you call an uncle up?
I am running out of uncles, and let me explain to you. Why should I have to call for cash when it is hard for a lady of my age and health to get that thing, when for you it's easy?
But you enjoy it.
And so will you.
No, Mum, please.
Don't mum me. This is business talk.
I ain't doing it.
Girl, you is. Because truth is, I made you. You are my flesh. You can't escape that. I made your head. What's in your head? Without me, you're nothing. Without me, you don't exist. You have no lips, you have no womb, you have no words. So serve me with the love I deserve. Come on now, do what mother tells you because she loves you. Because this mama loves you so much it comes slurping over the edges like when a fat man jumps into the toddler pool. And we want fat men flying like pigs into our money pond.
More. More. More.
Yeah, come on. Do your top a little. Do it like this. Just a little. You're driving mad. Hey, punter, this is all for you. Show a little chest. Blink those eyes and you can cry. They like it if you're paining. That's better, girl. You're looking good. Ain't she looking good?
More. More. More.
You like it when this guy jerks off, don't you?
Yeah, that's right, Mama.
Say it louder. Tell the man.
Yeah, that's right, Mama. That's right. I love it. It makes me wet.
All done. Don't I look after you? Don't I look after you?
Yes, Mama, you look after me.
Don't I love you? I'm asking, don't I love you? That's a straight question. Why do you want to beat it around the bushes?
Yes, you love me.
And you love me too?
Of course I love you, Mama.
Good. You can say it louder later, but for now I've got it on tape. You're lucky you've got me. You're lucky you never have a mama like my had.
Okay, no more. I'm not listening.
Because compared to my mama, I am to you like a big glob of love, sweet honey on a ladle. She got me in the coal shed while she has her fancy man toasting in front of the fire. She beat me, she heat me, she freeze me. She make me shiver in the street waiting for uncles. She make me give head in the coal shed, backshot in the parking lot.
Hand job on the gear knob.
You can take the piss. But all I ever make you do is show a little skirt. Don't hurt. They look, but they ain't touching. It's all sweet. Oh, I need to get some more supplies. Can I get you some little treat? Oh, it's no good being down. That makes it 10 times worse. And then the punters don't click, so come on. Give me a smiley face. That's better. And you take care. Don't miss any calls.
I won't be like that to you. I'm going to look after you, build you up, make you strong. I'm going to be the best mother. I'm going to break the chain.
What the fuck? What the fuck? Get off me! Don't touch me! I'll kill you! Leave me alone! I never asked for this! She's like needles of fire stabbing me! Who caught the tidy bug? Give me filth, give me shit, give me squalid.
Grandma, Grandma, it's me.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Gyal, your granddaughter.
Why you call me?
I never called you, you're dead.
I know I'm dead. You think I'm stupid? You think I asked to come here? Something call me. Some bothersome, some irk and inkling, some itch I've got to scratch.
Oh, that was me.
Oh, you stupid, you just goes fuckwit. Made me remember sad fucking songs and kids singing round the tree and the snow falling and everybody happy. I'll show you what Granny does to fools like you.
My dead mother, who I am mortally scared of, she's in my house and threatens my little girl, who is everything to me. What should I do? What can I do? Have I got the strength to oppose that woman? The force that made me, who abused me all those years? Can I let her destroy the little girl I raised and who brings in so much cash? Leave my little girl alone.
Go on, finish me. Put me out of my misery.
You're dead already. I saw you burn.
And I ain't had a minute peace since. Something about you, how I hurt you, how I never got to say how much I love you, how you never came to see me in the hospital.
Because I didn't even know you were there. You fell over in the gutter, got crushed by Deliveroo. How am I going to see you?
And you hate me.
Well, that too.
And you poison me.
How?
You bring me vodka, gin and rum.
Because you send me to the shop for them.
And you mix the bleach in.
To keep you from pestilence.
Why did you never tell me I was drinking too much?
Because you beat me if I say any word.
Isn't a beating worth a mother's life?
Oh, you never listen. Always at me, on me, never a minute's peace.
That's you, on me. Always out and up to stuff.
Because you've always got an uncle round.
Everything. I do it for you. Because I love you so much. Because I know I'm doing wrong. Because I don't know how to do it right. It's like a sickness. It makes me hurt the thing I love most. Look at me now. Burning. No peace. I need to forgive you. And for you to forgive me.
Oh, excuse me, ladies, if I puke with joy. And one thing you forgot. The Gyal is the mama of the ma. And I got a say in this.
Well, then join us in our happy sadness lady hug.
No way, because mama, if grandma was bad, then you got to be worse. And me, I got to be the baddest.
She poisoned me. Ain't that bad enough?
Why don't she poison me then?
It's always selfie me a clock with her.
You neglect to mistreat me. Don't you see? You have made this snowflake goddess with no pain, no misery, no angle, no cred. What the fuck? Were you playing at?
Leave her alone. She had it bad.
Not bad enough, old lady. You failed her. That means you fail me too. Because that's the worst thing a ma can do, is to give her daughter some trauma, some big injury, some big pain to work through to magnificence.
Careful of your unborn child.
Because I tell you, once you have a child, that child will have every kind of misery I can give her. I will pile the pain on her. She will never rest, but for the hatred, cold, hunger, neglect, she will be a monster. She will be famous, and I will show you, failed up ladies, what it is to bring a winsome girl into the world.
Oh, Lord be praised.
It's a boy.
It isn't your responsibility.
But
often late, Mrs. Class.
No.
Don't enable him.
He's been arrested.
Well, he hasn't a good attitude. Those rings, skulls, aren't they? His hat pulled down.
Awesome.
In the eye. Not all unconscious bias, you know. Why exactly did they arrest him?
Because they found his DNA.
Can't argue with science.
He'd been robbed.
Are you his real sister?
To come himself.
You're not using a slang term.
What?
Same mother and father, or at least one of them the same?
Well, yeah. Like I said, we're brother and sister.
This baby father thing, I'll never understand.
My brother doesn't have any...
I've read the reports. Masculine drive, testosterone, but still.
Well, his clothes were stolen. That's why DNA was found.
You need proof, you know? I'm sure you want to defend your bro, but have you read the reports? The academic and government surveys? I thought not. I have. So, please don't judge me as a privileged white woman in an academic enclave. I've made sure there is diversity throughout my department. All of my team have completed the course.
He'd never steal.
Statistics say that young black youths are overrepresented in crime.
They found his DNA on the knife, but that was because they take it.
Why was he carrying a knife?
He didn't have a knife.
You just said his DNA was found.
Yeah, but...
I'll have to take this further. I have to be careful.
I just wanted to explain why his work is late.
Was anyone hurt?
Yes, but...
You appreciate it is my responsibility to report this incident, this violent incident. I suppose he's been in a gang all his life.
He's not part of a gang.
Let's be logical, shall we? You claim that your brother Wilfred was the victim of a burglary.
Yeah, that's correct. He'd been to the library doing an all-nighter.
Well, there'll be a police report to back it up. Well, is there a police report?
We didn't report it.
Why didn't he report this so-called burglary?
Because we're from Newham.
Yes?
Well, in Newham, you don't go to the police.
Oh, well, I suggest that is a case of prejudice. On your part. You think the police are against you. That, you see, is prejudice. You need proof in writing to support a case. Let's say that I believe this robbery story.
Well, I saw his room.
Right.
I just came to explain why his assignment's late.
Oh, it's a long way past late assignments. We're dealing with a criminal offence. Although I admire your loyalty, you need to appreciate the type.
Type?
I have studied the demographic, and I accept he's had systemic disadvantages that make him predisposed to criminality.
No, he goes to church, he's in the gospel choir.
Is your father at home?
No.
Exactly, disadvantaged.
He's dead. My father's dead, he had sickle cell disease, then a series of strokes.
I don't want you to think that I don't understand, I do. As a woman, I've been the victim of comments and remarks. I can empathise. My great-grandmother was Jewish, came to Britain as a refugee.
Yeah, it's not quite the same.
I believe we all matter.
Right. Can he have the extension?
We need to be sure of the outcome of the charge.
He's worked for 4 years. He's got a place at teacher training college.
Not if he has a criminal record.
He doesn't. He won't.
A knife?
It wasn't his.
Didn't he work as a security guard last semester?
We needed the money.
And he's a bodybuilder.
He likes to go to the gym, yeah?
It's important that you consider all viewpoints.
I do, but...
It's not binary, right and wrong, black and white. The police are not always wrong.
All right.
Let me explain. Your younger brother broke the law.
What? No.
Oh, no, not your younger brother.
Yeah, but he didn't break...
You tell me there was a burglary, but there's no evidence. No written proof. You have to understand what steps the authorities have to take.
Well, he has a witness.
You expect me to accept the late admission of his final essay because of a crime. You think I should not report this law-breaking to the dean?
Well, he was with me when the crime was committed.
Be careful. A bright, sassy young woman shouldn't give up her future. Sassy. Yes. Compliment, a bright, cheerful word.
No, it's a box her in. Label her.
Nonsense.
Say she has ambitions way above her station.
Let me tell you that your ambition for your brother, even your younger brother, could destroy you. Leave him be. Tell him to accept his punishment, start again. Reboot, as it were.
Well, there are photos.
What?
Photos of us together when the crime was committed. We weren't even in London, we were in Bristol.
Photoshop can be detected.
Well, we were on the news.
You broke lockdown.
What?
You disobeyed the law.
He's not guilty of a knife crime.
Any infringement has to be taken seriously. Have you told the police?
Sorry?
Have you told the police about this infringement of the lockdown?
No, because we didn't.
You'll both get a criminal record. You won't be able to become a teacher.
I'm studying politics.
You should have read the reports then. Know your rights.
He was staying at my flat in Bristol throughout the lockdown because his room in London had been trashed. We didn't travel, we didn't break lockdown, we wore masks.
Masks?
Because of the virus?
Difficult to recognise you behind a mask.
There's always something.
Beg your pardon?
Excuse me. So, can he have the extension for his final essay?
I'll have to take guidance.
If I get a letter from his solicitor, a statement from the police saying that he's innocent.
And the protest in Bristol?
I didn't say we were protesting. We were out for a walk and we were interviewed by a reporter. I'll send you the clip.
It's on the news?
Yes.
Oh. Well, in that case, I could consider it.
Could you confirm that in writing?
What?
If I email you and say that after our conversation, you agree to give Wilfred an extension till the end of the month, based on the information I provided.
You want it in writing?
Yes.
From me?
One has to be careful.
Well, that's it. That is it. We're done. Log off, go home, do whatever you need to do, but we are finished. It's just my face now, for good. No, just to say a huge thank you to everyone at home and watching this for coming along tonight and watching these plays. We really do appreciate all of your support, so we really can't thank you enough. Also, a huge shout out and a huge thank you to the writers for sharing your work and getting involved in Play Club in the first place, and to the actors and directors for bringing these pieces to life and crafting them in such a way. I really do appreciate all of that. And a big shout out to Hal Darling for editing all of this together. I would have been really lost without you. So that's very helpful that you were there. We hope to run future similar events like Play Club and to offer more opportunities and projects to the next generation of playwrights. You can become a member of London Playwrights Workshop for as little as £3.61 a month, which I believe is less than a cafe near a coffee. This will give you access to a whole host of resources and opportunities, including our annual Write a Play scheme, which is coming back for January 2021. You can find out more details about that on the blog, and we hope to see you there, that you can join us for that scheme. We are a non-for-profit company, and as I mentioned at the start, any donations are super welcome for us to continue support writers and to run future similar projects. So please do consider making a donation via the link below or on the blog, or becoming a member, whichever you like. So that leaves me just to say thank you so much again for joining us, and I'd like to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year, and I hope to see you at some point in 2021. See you later.